In this video, I will show you the easiest method I found to add a spindle sensor to a CNC machine using a couple of popular breakout boards. My method should also work with Arduino, Rasberri Pi, and other microcontrollers. I will focus on CNC breakout boards and how they work, how speed sensors work, how to configure Mach 3, then how to test your setup for accuracy. I am confident that my methods will work with Linux CNC and other CNC programs. Before trying my methods, carefully research and understand how your CNC system works. I will not be responsible for any damage, accidents, or injuries. One of the nice things about these CNC breakout boards is that typically each input connects to an optical coupler. This helps protect the board and the computer from damage. When an input pin connects to ground, a small amount of current flows through the LED. Light from the LED strikes the base of a phototransistor, allowing even a smaller amount of current to flow from the computer's parallel cable through a resistor back to ground, switching the computer's input from high to low. Let's begin with proximity and Hall effect sensors. They react to a changing magnetic field. When a magnet approaches either one of these sensors, their output voltage rises. Both of these sensors require a 5-volt DC source and an inverter circuit when they are connected to the input of a breakout board. This digital tachometer application needs only a proximity sensor, DC source, and a magnet to work properly. Notice how the LED becomes brighter as the magnet passes by the sensor. This is because the proximity sensor's output voltage rises each time the magnet passes by. Another method to add a speed sensor to a CNC machine is to mount a photo sensor across a thin disc that is attached to the spindle's shaft. When the spindle turns, a narrow slot in the disc allows light to strike a phototransistor. This causes a sensor's output to rise high every time light strikes the sensor. A 5-volt DC source and an inverter circuit is also required for this sensor when using a breakout board. Reed sensors have contacts that close when they are near a magnet. They are commonly used in treadmills to sense the treadmill speed. They do not require a 5-volt DC source or an inverter circuit. They can be connected directly to the input of a breakout board. A Reed sensor has no polarity. You cannot hook them up backwards. When the spindle's magnet passes across the face of a Reed sensor, its contacts close, allowing the computer's input pin to change from high to low. Reed sensors are readily available and inexpensive. They can also be salvaged from treadmills. There are 5 input pins on the left edge of my breakout board. Pins number 10, 11, 12, 13, and 15. Pin 10 is commonly used as an e-stop input. I connected my Reed sensor between the input pin 15 and to input ground. Pins 11, 12, and 13 can still be used for other purposes such as inputs for an end of travel switch or a probe switch. Configuring a Reed sensor is easy using Mach 3. Click on Configure, select Ports and Pins, the Input Signals tab, then scroll down until you find Index. The settings are Enabled, Check, Port 1, Pin 15, Active Low, Check, Not Emulated, and No Hotkey. Continue scrolling down until you see Timing. Again, Enabled, Check, Port 1, Pin 15, Active Low, Check, Not Emulated, and No Hotkey. Click on OK, then Reset. I also configured my spindle pulleys to maximum RPM 4000, pulley number 1, and ratio 1. I tested that the reed switch is connected and working properly. I used a diagnostic screen of Mach 3. The index light turns on when a magnet approaches the face of the reed sensor and turns off when the magnet is removed, indicating that it is working. There are a couple of ways to verify that the reed switch is measuring RPM properly. One way is to use a motor with a known RPM. Mach 3 indicates 1790 RPM. This is because I increased the outer diameter of the motor shaft by the thickness of the magnet. Plus, there is an air gap between the magnet and the reed sensor. Whenever the outer diameter of a rotating shaft increases, the outer surface speed also increases. Another way to verify that a reed sensor is accurate is to compare the spindle speed to the RPM displayed by a tachometer. To do this, I carefully placed a reed sensor next to the tachometer's proximity sensor. I then connected the reed sensor to the milling machine's 6-axis breakout board and configured Mach 3. The tachometer RPM and Mach 3 RPM were nearly identical. To summarize, I explained how breakout boards, proximity sensors, Hall effect sensors, and photosensors work, why reed sensors are the easiest sensor to add to a CNC machine's breakout board. I hope you found this video interesting and informative. If you like this video, please give me a thumbs up. And if you would like to see more videos, subscribe. In my next video, I will demonstrate a simple circuit that I made and connected to a common breakout board to allow me to manually and automatically control a DC motor speed using only Mach 3. Thanks for watching.